हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, होप्स एवरीवन इज फिट एंड फाइन। सो स्टूडेंट्स, वी वर्स इन योर चैप्टर नंबर 5 एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर वर्स इंट्रोडक्शन टू योर विजुअल बेसिक। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन माय लास्ट क्लास आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू हाउ वी कैन असाइन अ वैल्यू टू अ वेरिएबल, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय असाइनमेंट स्टेटमेंट्स अलॉन्ग विद देयर फॉर्मेट एंड एग्जाम्पल्स। I think so regarding my last day's class, no one has any sort of doubts. So today students, we will move to another new topic of the same chapter, that is your arithmetic operators. Now students, when you are getting this term arithmetic operators, what do you mean by this? You can say arithmetic means here what? You will get here certain mathematical what? Mathematical symbols. And when you are talking about operators, okay, here operators, you will get here different types of symbols. So by taking together the name of arithmetic operator, it means you're using different sorts of your arithmetic signs or mathematical symbols. Sign or symbols together you can say as your operators. So here students, in Visual Basic you will get here different types of operators, okay, and you will get here their specific functions. As in your mathematics you have got their addition, division, subtraction, is not it? You have got different types of symbols in your maths where you have done different sorts of calculations. Now here also in computer you will get here different types of mathematical symbols, where you will find that the functions are quite similar that you are calculating while doing your maths. Clear? But you will find there are certain change in your symbols, okay? The symbols will be the difference. Symbols will be different, but the functions will be the same. Clear, students? So everyone look at your table 5.2. Everyone have a look on your 5.2. In 5.2 you will find there a table, okay, table 5.2, where you will get a list of your arithmetic operators in your Visual Basic. So the first mathematical or arithmetical operator that you are seeing on the table is your, can you say me what is this symbol? This plus sign, what is the symbol of this plus sign? It is your addition, okay? This plus sign is the symbol of your addition. So here, it's very simple. You need to plus it, okay? You need to add up, you need to add up the numbers and the sign of this addition will be the same. So it's clear to everyone. Then you will come to the next arithmetic operator, that is your minus. Okay, see the symbol of this arithmetic operator, second arithmetic operator, that is what? That is your minus. It means your subtraction. Okay, here the symbol is same, plus, addition, minus, subtraction, computer language also they will insert the same symbol. Clear? Then you come to the third arithmetic operator. This is what? This is the sign of a star, okay? But in computer language, it is known as your multiplication. In computer language, it is known as your what? Multiplication. This symbol of star, in computer language, it is identified as your multiplication. So everyone knows to multiply. Multiply the numbers. So see here in the example, 5 into 6 into 2. 5 into 6 how much? 5 into 6 is a 30. And 30 into 6, 30 into 2. 30 into 2 is how much? It is your 60. So multiplication also is clear to everyone. But the sign, the symbol of this multiplication sign in computer language will be your star. Okay. In general, the multiple sign is what? It is your cross, is not it? In your maths, you are doing as your cross sign. But in computer language, the symbol of your multiplication will be your star. Clear? Then next you come to your next arithmetic operator, that is your fourth one. Fourth one is your exponent. Now when you are talking about exponent, I think so you peoples have done in your earlier classes. Is not it? Here you can say whatever the roots, okay, root I think so everyone has got. It may be your square root, it may be your this one cube root, okay. Now if I am saying 5 exponent 2, exponent symbol is like this, okay, look at the table properly. 5 exponent 2 means 5 root over 2. So 5 root over 2 how much? Means 5 is how many times? 5 root over 2, it means 5 is your 2 times. 5 into 5. 5 into 5 is how much? 5 into 5, it is your 25. Same way, if I am giving you 4 exponent 2, means 4 square. It means what? 4 exponent 2 means 4 square. 4 into 4, it means what? 4 into 4, 16. Okay, then again, 7 exponent, okay, 7 exponent 2. 7 exponent 2, it means 7 is how many times? 7 will be 2 times, 7 into 7 into 7. So it will be what? 7 sevens are 49. Clear this much? These four functions are clear: addition, subtraction, multiplication and exponent. Now let's move to the fifth one. Fifth arithmetic operator is your division. I think so everyone knows division. But the sign of this division in computer language is different. Okay, in your general maths you have got the division sign in different way. But here in computer language the division sign will be in the form of your slash. Okay, it will be in the form of your slash. And the slash, it means in your way you can't give. Your own thinking or your own choice you can't give. The slash is also in this way. How you see in division, it has given slash, you have to give in that way itself. You can't give your own choice. Clear this much? So division, everyone knows, 11 by 4. It will be how much? 11 by 4, 2.75. Clear? Then you see integer, integer division. Integer division, the symbol will be what? The symbol will be like this. Whatever you are seeing on the table, integer division symbol, it will be like that. When we are talking about integer division, it means what? Integers, it may be your negative also. Okay, it may be your negative. And you can say that in computer language, when you are getting the decimals, okay, when you are getting the decimals, in there itself, you can catch that one as your integer. Now, 20 divided by 3. 20 divided by 3. Look at this example of the integer division. When I am saying you 20 divided by 3, it means what? When I am saying 20 divided by 3, there you will get a decimal. Is not it? You will get a decimal where you will get also a remainder. Is not it? So whatever will be in your cushion, that one only you have to place it. Clear this much? This much is clear. Means here in computer language, integer division, you have to discard the decimal points. Okay, you have to discard, means you have to eliminate the decimal numbers. Okay, you are not going to place the values after decimal. Whatever the values are there before the decimal, okay, whatever the values are there before the decimal, you are going to place only that. Clear, students? 20 divided by 3, you have got 6, where you will get again decimal points as well as you will get the remainders. Yes or no? So whatever the values that is placed before the decimal, that will be your integer division. Clear this much? Then students, you will come to your modulus. MOD, it means your modulus. Now here what happens? Here what you are going to do? Yes? Here in this one, modulus, you will find that it is quite similar with your integer division. Okay, it is quite similar with your integer division. Now here what happens, whatever will be there in your remainder, okay, in division, okay, in division, whatever the things will be there for your remainder, you will cast that one as your modulus. Clear? For example, if you are dividing 20 divided by 3, okay, 20 divided by 3. Now here, whatever will be there in your remainder, that will be in your modulus. Clear? Clear this much? No doubts? So how many operators you have got here? 7 operators. Okay, you have got here 7 operators. What are they? Addition, subtraction, multiplication, exponent, division, integer division, and the last one is your modulus. Clear? Modulus, it means whatever there will be in the remainder after dividing, whatever will be there in the remainder, it comes as your modulus. Clear? Then integer division means what? Whatever you are dividing, okay, the values before the decimal will be your integer. Means the portion after decimal you are not going to take. And the rest you know it well. Exponent also I have explained you where you will get the square roots, cube roots, whatever. That will be your particular answer. So students, this much is clear to everyone. No doubts regarding this. So students, there will be one question. Everyone take out to your page number 91. Page number 91. In page number 91, you will find one question, that is your number E. Number E. List all the arithmetic operators used in Visual Basic. List all the arithmetic operators used in Visual Basic. Clear? First, write the question in your computer copy. Then for the answer, you are going to take out page number 84. In 84, you are going to make this table. Okay, you are going to make this table with the help of your scale and pencil. Make this table and write with your pens. Clear? You have to write operator, operation and all these examples. Clear? 7 operators. Okay, as well as write their operations and example. Make a table. Without a table, don't write. First, you make a table with the help of your pencil and scale. Then you write it. I think so, it's clear to everyone. Arithmetic operators, no doubts. Because you have got all these things in your previous class. In general maths, you have got all this. Is not it? So, students, this is the answer for your question number E. Okay, list all the arithmetic operators used in Visual Basic. Answer is in your page number 84. Make this table very neatly and cleanly. Clear? So student, so this was the end of our chapter. We can say that our chapter number 5 fully explanation as well as the question answer part is over. So, what you are going to do, whatever answers that I have given you, you learn as your homework. Clear? In my next class, I will give you some questions as your revision. So, you must learn all the answers that I have given to you from chapter number 5. So, students, I am winding my class here. Thank you to all. And have a nice day ahead.